everyone. Carrie and I are in the Gator, and we are on a rescue mission of a calf. Bear, she is our cow that has frostburn ears and no tail. She was born in a snowstorm several years ago, lost her ears and tails. She had a calf a few days ago. Calf has been fine. Calf's probably, what, a week old?
Yeah, she was born Saturday, last Saturday.
During the blizzard?
Yeah.
Okay, so she had been fine. Mom has been super good. But calf just seems to not be thriving. And yesterday I noticed looked a little bit just slow and just didn't have as much spunk as I would like the calf to have at this age. So we're gonna go get her and bring her in. The wind is atrocious today. We're supposed to have gusts of like 50 miles an hour and it is blowing. So we're gonna go get calf, bring calf in, see what's going on with the calf, and then decide what to do with Bear. It's warm here in the grow room. I've got a space heater. I'm gonna put the space heater on her. She's cold. So easy way to tell temperature is put your finger in their mouth. They run about 101 degrees. You can see she's super skinny. I looked at mom's udder yesterday. She appears to have an udder, but it seems for whatever reason, baby's probably not getting enough milk. So warm, then food. All right, here she is. I've got her right in front of the space heater, got it turned up to high. We'll get that calf warmer out. I had it in the sales barn, but not in the shop, and I want it in the shop because it's warmer just in general in the shop because the shop is heated. So just moving that around real quick, then we'll throw her in the calf warmer. Come here, baby girl. Oh, sorry, hon. Temperature starts to come up. All right, calf has been in here for about 40 minutes. I don't expect her to be warm and up to temperature. It usually takes about an hour per degree that you need to warm up, but I'm gonna take temperature, found a thermometer, check her mouth, and I've peeked in on her. She's holding her head up. She's breathing deeply. One of the great things about the calf hut is that they breathe in warm air and that helps warm them. So not just blowing air on them, but them breathing that nice warm air that gets trapped in here is really beneficial and helpful when warming them up. So I'm gonna take her temperature. But I didn't check to see if it would turn on. All right. Can do the. Oh, she's still cold, but she's not like icy cold. More just feels like chilled in her mouth. Does she have a suck reflex? Let's see. Not really. She doesn't want to, a little bit of suck reflux. That's good. Okay, definitely she's warming up. I'm going to try and find a battery or something for this and see if I can get this to work. Okay, I went to town. I got a thermometer. We're going to check on our calf. Is that she maybe has a tummy ache. She does not appear to have diarrhea or scours, but she could have the beginning of like E. coli or salmonella or something like that. Potentially caused her to go off feed and not nurse. And so before I put anything into her, I'm gonna check and make sure she's not running a temperature. She could be chilled and running a temperature or a fever at the same time. And so depending on what her temperature is going to determine our course of action. She does have more of a suck reflux than she did when she came in. Let me look at your gums. I would like to look in your mouth. And then also he told me whether she's dehydrated. Her skin does snap back, and her saliva's not sticky. Like, it's a little sticky, but think about when you get dehydrated and your mouth gets really dry and it's just really sticky and thick. She's not super sticky. I'm assuming she's got some dehydration, but if she was dehydrated, we would do electrolytes first and then do milk. She is sucking on my finger. I think she'll probably take a bottle, so just we're gonna have to decide which. If we want to do if I'm going to do electrolytes or if we're going to do milk. Milk would obviously give calories and energy, but it has to be digested, whereas electrolytes would just be absorbed easier. And then I'm going to have to keep an eye on diarrhea because we're going to reactivate her gut when we put milk into her. And so that may cause the diarrhea to come out if she's got E. coli or salmonella or something like that. And then that will be additional treatment. So let's take a temperature. She's at 93.7 right now, and it's climbing. So she's cold still. Her mouth is considerably warmer, but that's also from the warm air. So she's reading 94.2, and it seems to have quit moving at that point. So at this point, I gotta get her warm before we put anything into her. So, more time in the warmer. She topped out at 94.4, and she should be about 100, 101. Okay, it's been several hours. It's now early evening and, you know, not afternoon. So I have already peeked in here. I've been checking on her and continuing to take temperature, but she's up. That's a great sign. Last time I checked her, which was about an hour ago, she was at 99.4. So I want to get her to like 101.5. I'm assuming that she's there since she's standing up. This is a great sign. So we're gonna do one more temperature check. This is just some lube to make things more comfortable. We'll see if she'll stand. You're a cobweb on me, honey. Oh, your belly looks empty. Okay, we're gonna make sure that she's not running a fever still. I did make up some milk replacer. So I think earlier I said 100 to 101. Actually, they can be 101.5 to 102.5 is normal. Thirsty, baby? Yeah, we're gonna get you some food. She's 101.7, so she's perfect. So, okay, like I said earlier, I've talked to a vet. I'm not a vet. Do not take vet advice from me, and this may not work for you. But the plan is Scour's Guard, a tablet. I'm gonna give her some OGH paste, which will help with gut bacteria, and then a pint of milk. I'm gonna put her in the barn and see how she does. Tomorrow, I will bring Mom back in, depending on how she does overnight. I will put her in a stall that has a heater so that she does have some heat. And we'll see how she does throughout the night. And so I'm gonna do a pint of milk right now, just small amounts, and probably in about 90 minutes or so, if she drinks this, I will do more. If she won't drink it, I'm gonna tube her. So let's medicate. Okay, so I'm gonna do the OGH paste first. This is a supplementary feed for calves containing a source of live, naturally occurring microorganisms. So it's good for gut health. That's real thick and real pasty. That's the name, OGH paste. All right, can they see you? That one. Just a moment. This is a Scour's bolus. This will help with E. coli and salmonella and a variety of other things. Swallow
she bit me.
Okay, so because she potentially has, E. coli or salmonella or some sort of gut, infection, or it's not a gut infection, but, she's got something going on. This bottle will be marked and it will be only used for her. I won't use this with the other two bottle caps that I have. She's sucking, that's great. It is something that you don't want to use you don't want any cross contamination. I'm putting her in a stall by herself and we'll see how she does, overnight. And I'm expecting diarrhea to occur. Hopefully that's not what occurs. And then if it's not that, then I'm gonna have to call the vet and see. It might be mom and it might be her milk. And I'll probably run mom in tomorrow and see what we can. I'm gonna bring mom in tomorrow regardless. But if diarrhea doesn't occur with this one, I don't know why she went off feed. And I don't know why she was so cold. An 8-day old calf shouldn't be that cold. This is great that she's drinking. Really, really great that she's drinking and able to stand. But we're doing small amounts to start out with. So I think when I first went out to go get her, we said she was born on Saturday and looked and she was born on, what is today? She's 8 days old. She was born right after the snowstorm. Today's the 16th. Separated from the other one so the other bottle caps do not get it. She's gonna go to the barn, so let's go put her in the barn. Alright, so she has got her own stall. She did try to walk, but I just decided to carry her. I did stop and weigh her. At the grain bin, she weighs 65 pounds. She's 8 days old. Ideally, I'd like to see her way more. She is extremely sunken in. So, I know she's slightly dehydrated. I do think milk was the right choice rather than electrolytes because her mouth is wet. Her skin is bouncing back. She needs calories. So, 90 minutes, I'm going to feed her again. She has heat. She's going to be here by herself. I will check on her frequently. And hopefully she'll just lay down and kind of rest and stay warm. Do you hear the lambs? All right, so second pint. Let's see if we can get her up and see if she wants to eat. Okay. She hasn't pooped yet. Mouth feels warm. All good signs. Okay, let's stand her up. Can you get up? Stand up. She's not as enthusiastic about drinking this time as she was the first bottle, but she is drinking. It's not your guys' bottle? I'm not super concerned that she doesn't. I'm trying to talk. I'm not super concerned that she doesn't want to drink. She still is drinking. But she really probably hasn't had food in several hours, probably like 12. And, you know, I just fed her 90 minutes ago. And it's just about small amounts. They're so noisy. So just small amounts. Oh, there she goes. The fact that she can stand and drink upright is amazing. There we go. Break. And she was sleeping. Oh, hey, Emu. No. Not the camera. Stop it.
It's not for you, okay? It's not for you. You don't need to touch everything.
All right, now the emus can't get you and you're crooked. She didn't drink a ton, but she drank some. We're gonna try a little bit more. Break. Do you need a break? got a little bit left. You want more? Drink like 3/4 of this, so I'm super happy with that. Nighttime bottle for everybody is in, I don't know, just under 2 hours, so we'll do another pint then, and I'll do one probably at like 2 a.m. or so. Okay, so here's what has happened in the last 24 hours. She's doing okay. She has been eating every 2 to 4 hours, eating just a little over a pint at her last feeding, mostly around a pint. I did not bring Mom in, and there's a couple reasons why I didn't end up bringing Mom in. This morning, about noon or so, when I checked her, her udder was full, but not engorged, not. At that point, I would assume, well, I know that she'd been off feed for at least 24 hours, if not even 36. And I, at this point, am working off the fact that Mom is probably not producing enough milk for her. And part of the reason I'm making that assumption is she has not developed diarrhea. She finally, just this afternoon, had her first bowel movement, and it is not diarrhea. It is loose, but it has some texture to it. So she did not get the diarrhea that I was expecting if she had E. coli or Salmonella. I'm not saying that we're still, I'm not completely out of the woods with her, but her gut is working, and it's not the catastrophic situation that I was potentially expecting. So, and Mom has kind of given up. Mom looked for her a little bit. I think Mom knew that she wasn't doing well. And even when I took her, she had been, they'd been Velcroed together for days. And, you know, that day Bear went off and ate. And that was kind of the first time that that had really happened. It took me days to get her tagged because Bear was super protective and they were always together. Usually they'll leave them after about 24 hours to go in and eat. And it took days for me to get her tagged. So we're gonna get her up, feed her a bottle. And she was just up. I was feeding the other bottle calves, and she was just up and actually kind of bawling. So, good signs. All right, come on, baby. Let's have some milk. Come on. Can you stand? She is still really, she doesn't have as much energy as I would like her to have. Get the shavings out, okay? And I would like her to drink a little bit more volume at one time, but when they're nursing with Mom, they have snacks. And they, you know, they drink 10 to 12 times a day, whereas bottle calves, you know, I do 3 bottles a day for the bottle calves once they're a couple days old. So we got to get her volume up. That would be helpful. She is going to get fed in the middle of the night again. I fed her about 3:30 this morning, and then she got fed at 5:30 and 7:30, and I got the whole schedule on the whiteboard in the shop. But I think we're making progress. I'm not going to say we're out of the woods yet. Is that nummy? Good job, baby. You finished it. You finished it. So I did decide I could bring Mom in and I could try and keep them in the grills, put her back on Mom, try and supplement her. But given how potentially protective Mom is, it's honestly just a fight that I don't want to fight every day. And there's no way for me to really know how much she's getting off of Mom. Obviously, I would probably be able to tell by how much bottle she would drink from me, but I just don't know that that's a fight I want to fight. I'm already making bottles. I'm already buying milk replacer. I think, and because I also want to keep a really close eye on if she develops diarrhea, and that gets harder in a corral, and I don't know that Mom would do super well here in the barn, and I don't know that I would be able to get in a corral. It would be a fight every single time. So I got to pick my battles. I only have so much time in a day and a lot of things to accomplish every day. So honestly, making bottles is the easier thing. That's what I'm going to do. So I feel like that's the best choice. That's what we're going to go with. Her name's going to be Gretchen. So we've got Gertie and Chad and Gretchen. So three bottle caps. It is cold and wet and windy out, and we had like snow squalls all day, so I threw some hay down for Gus and Ethel. Usually they eat outside, but they wanted to be inside. So they're in here eating. There's some chickens. As usual, there's an emu. Do you want a bottle first? No, he doesn't want a bottle. Oh, wants a bottle. You guys are always so helpful. The donkeys are naughty and they keep knocking down my emu feeder. So there's a chair deterrent until I can figure something else out. And I put bigger screws and stuff in it. How's it going, Jenny? You helping? Okay. And then if you missed the short video that I did, we've got Miss Gertie, of course. She just had a bottle. Yes, she did. Hi, baby. And then this is Chad. He was very knuckled under when he was born and could not stand. Weighed 90 pounds. And his mom had three of her four teeth blown, and her udder was extremely engorged. And I knew as she approached calving and her udder just deteriorated that her calf was going to struggle to latch, and I was going to have to keep a super close eye on him. But the fact that he was knuckled under just made it so that I brought him in. And he was slightly chilled when I brought him in, and 90-pound calves just kind of, it's just a hard birth and takes them a minute to kind of get going. And with the little bit of hypothermia that he had, I ended up tube feeding him. But he's doing really well. So he's pretty much straightened out. He just also had his bottle. So he's like, nah, I'm not getting up. I'm just going to chill. So, and then I have two baby lambs. These are Dorper lambs, just like Lamma Lamma Ding Dongs. Look how tiny they are. They're so tiny and so cute. So two little ewe lambs, bottle lambs, born right after the blizzard at a ranch here, not that far from where I'm at. And same place that I got the other two lambs from. So they're part of the ranch now, and they've been super cute. They also just had bottles. So everybody's ready for a little nap. So lots of bottle babies this year, and that's okay. They're alive. They're healthy-ish. Making improvement. Lambs are doing great. These two are doing great. So it's what needs to be done. I want healthy, live calves. If I have to bottle feed, that's what I'll do. So thank you guys for watching. I appreciate it so, so, so much. And more calving content is coming soon. I am trying so desperately to get a live birth caught on camera, and they're being sneaky. And hopefully in the next couple of days, I can make that happen. So thank you again for being here. Have a great day, and I'll see you next time.